Good morning, everyone. Today, we'll be discussing about the last two topics of this chapter, the Earth in the solar system. But before we begin with the last two topics, we'll just have a brief review of whatever we have studied till date. We had studied about our solar system, the sun and the eight planets, which revolve around the sun in a fixed elliptical path known as the orbit. We had defined solar system, that is the sun, its planets and the other objects in orbit are all together known as the solar system. Our solar system is made up of sun, eight planets, their moons, asteroids and meteoroids, comets. Then we had discussed about the characteristics of the sun, planets, our planet Earth. We had discussed about the history of planet Earth. I've given you some homework which I need. You need to submit it on time. We discussed about moon, asteroids, meteoroids. Then we had a brief overview of the chapter. Then I had discussed about universe and astronomy. What are stars and constellations? What is a galaxy? What are comets? And then we discussed about the eight planets of the solar system in detail. That is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. Now, phases of the moon. Phases means the changing shape of the moon. We never see the moon in same shape when we look at the sky, right? The shape of moon, it keeps on changing. And that changing shape of the bright part of the moon is called its phase. And why this part, why there is a change in shape of moon? Shape of moon, it keeps on changing. The reason behind is that the moon, it revolves around the Earth, right? The moon, it takes 27.3 days to take one complete round of the Earth. Now, while it takes round of the Earth, it receives sunlight at different angles. The portion in which it receives the sunlight, it is visible to us, and the portion which does not receive the sunlight, we are not able to see it. That is why the shape of the moon is different every time we look in the sky, right? It keeps on changing while it is revolving around the Earth, right? All the shape of the moon is round only. The shape will not change. It's just that which part is receiving the sunlight and is visible to us, and which part is not receiving the sunlight and is not visible to us. All right, class. The changing shape, right? The changing shape of the bright part of the moon that we see is called its phase. Means why we are mentioning the bright part. The shape of the moon is not changing. It's just that the part which is receiving the sunlight is visible to us, and the part which is not receiving the sunlight is not visible to us. That is why we observe a change in shape. In actual, the shape is not changing. It's just that the portion which is receiving the sunlight is visible to human eyes, and the portion which is not receiving the sunlight is not visible to human eyes. So this is a clear picture now, right, which is showing the moon phases. Now, this is the moon which is revolving around the Earth. This is the moon which is revolving around the Earth. Now, while it is revolving around the Earth, you can see the picture, right? How is it receiving the sunlight? See, it's starting its revolution like this. Fine. This is your full moon. We are able to see. Then it is your waning gibbous. Means this only this portion is available. Then last quarter. then warning crescent means this shape is available, right? Then it is your new moon, which is not visible. Then it is your waxing crescent again, first quarter, waxing gibbous and full moon, right? Full moon, we are able to see the, like we are able to see the moon. New moon mein we are not able to see the moon. Now solar eclipse. Solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes in between the sun and the earth and cast its shadow on the earth. Lunar eclipse occurs when the earth comes in between the sun and the moon and cast its shadow on the moon, thus covering the moon. It always occurs on a full moon day. So discussing about the lunar and solar eclipse now. Eclipse is the partial or complete hiding of one heavenly body by shadow of another, right? If you can see, in solar eclipse, moon comes in between the sun and earth and it casts a shadow on the earth, right? Means one heavenly body is casting the shadow on another heavenly body, that is earth. In lunar eclipse, the earth comes in between the sun and moon and it casts a shadow on the moon, right? That is your lunar eclipse. Eclipse is the partial or complete hiding of one heavenly body by shadow of another. An eclipse is formed when shadow of the earth falls on the moon or the shadow of the moon falls on the earth. Two types of eclipse are there, solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes in between the sun and the earth and cast its shadow on the earth. Thus, in the region where the shadow falls, we cannot see the sun. It always occurs on a new moon day. Lunar eclipse occurs when the earth comes in between the sun and the moon and cast its shadow on the moon, thus covering the moon. It always occurs on a full moon day. So solar eclipse, it occurs on a new moon day, and your lunar eclipse occurs on a full moon day. Solar eclipse occurs when the moon comes in between the sun and the earth and casts its shadow on the earth. Thus, in the region where the shadow falls, we cannot see the sun. It always occurs on a new moon day and lunar eclipse on a full moon day. So coming back to this position again, new moon gives rise to your solar eclipse. Full moon gives rise to your lunar eclipse. New moon, the moon is not visible, right? Full moon mein the moon is visible. Your cycle starts from here. You're able to see moon from waxing crescent. It goes like this. And it when comes to new moon is not visible. Just because it happens in the daytime also, you know, most of the part of the moon is not able to receive the sunlight. So during new moon, your solar eclipse happens, and during your full moon, your lunar eclipse happens. So class, you will go through this once again. If any query is there, right, you will ask me on your WhatsApp group. Thank you.